The same government's company, government-linked company, is actually encouraging income divide. If the same government who says we want to bridge this gap, and if the same government is encouraging its company to actually encourage income divide, the rich become richer, the poor becomes poorer. What is the message that the government is sending? That is where we appealed to the government. We wrote to the Prime Minister. Our members even handed a flyer personally to him at the recent NTUC dinner. Despite that, we have not received any response. Here we have the government who says he wants to ensure every Malaysian lives a life which they can afford to live. That means we want a decent living wage. This is what we want. Any of these struggle now, and the campaign is to ensure every bank worker has a decent living wage. That is going to be our campaign. We want to ensure that we are not being left out. Because these CEOs can come and go. 1 year, 2 years, 3 years contract, they will leave, correct? And if they're going to squander everything and leave, and if there's going to be another financial crisis, then the next CEO will say, because we are having financial crisis, we have to cut the ages. Again, we become the victim. Brothers and sisters, we want this to be grabbed into our mind so that we, when we proceed with the campaign, we can justify that there is injustice done. There will not be any peace if injustice is there. If you want peace, you must cultivate justice. Do you agree? If you want peace, you must cultivate justice. And if you want to cultivate justice, you cannot speak by saying we want to bridge the gap. But at the same time, when you have the powers, you want your company to exercise income divide. That is not a moral thing to do. This is the message that we are sending to Maybank, which we have sent before. But Maybank is attempting to circumvent it and come up with so many other issues by saying that we are more interested in the in-house union and not interested in serving the members. Performance bonus is not an issue. All other trade disputes are not an issue. The only reason why NUBE is fighting is because of the in-house union. The in-house union was created to frustrate and deliberately to derail NUBE from fighting the cause of income divide. That is the fact. That is why, even to today, the Prime Minister of this country does not seem to have the political will to call up Maybank and say, make sure you give them a fair, decent salary. Recently, when they gave the share lots, for the Maybank employees, they gave share lots 1.0, 1.2, 1.5 lots. The top executive takes 500 lots. Look at the gap. Who is widening? If the government-linked company itself is widening the income divide, do you think the Prime Minister or the government of this country can tell a private company, please make sure the rich does not become richer, the poor doesn't become poorer, make sure you bridge the gap? They have no guts to say that. They cannot say that. Because the private sector will raise the question, are you not being a hypocrite? Your own government-linked company, you are not giving them a fair, deal. Why do you force me to give a fair deal? So brothers and sisters, we are Malaysians. We are concerned of this country. This country is a blessed country. We are multiracial, multi-regional, but we can sit together. And we are brothers and sisters. And NUBE must set as an example that we will continue this struggle and ensure that the wealth divide is corrected. And we have a decent living wage so that you can proudly work as a banker and you proudly take home your salary and tell your family this money is free from loans. No personal loan, no salary loan. We can afford. Otherwise, you will see a situation, a few wahi and a few CEOs out there and the masses are all begging. One is the bank will stop your loan. They say you got CTOS here, CQIS here. And then you will have a tough time with the banks. You will not have a peace of mind. And especially bank workers, the expectation from the employers is you must have integrity. Slight dishonesty, even by mistake, they say it is dishonesty and they expel us. We have seen it in the banking sector. The first question the industrial court chairman or the high court chairman will say, where was your integrity? You are the custodian of public fund. Why are you dishonest? In view of that, we are terminating. But who pushed us to that corner? Who pushed us to extend our members even still 10 million? It is the banks. They do not give us a living, decent living wage. One lot for any of you member and 500 lot for the CEO. You have worked for 30 years. The CEO just came 3 years. And he's taking the ESOPs 500 lots away. Are we going to keep quiet?
No.
Are we going to keep quiet?
No.
We will campaign and campaign and campaign and ensure that this income divide is bridged. Yeah. I also want to tell you that this is going to be a major crisis in Asian countries, especially the developing countries. This is going to be the major threat. If we do not resolve this, if the government do not take precautionary measures, we will find ourselves, like in Manila or in some university areas, where when you walk in the street, on the street, people come and scratch your back. People come and scratch your wallet. And in the process of it, we have seen in Malaysia people falling down and innocent women dying as a result of this social problem. We don't want this country to reach that situation. And at the same time, we do not want the top management to squander all the wealth of the bank. We should be shared by all of us. With that, brothers and sisters, once again, I want to thank each one of you.